is the first album that, I mean, I've always kind of written on the last albums, but I really took more a creative thing completely with this album. I wrote a lot more, which is cool. It's like my, you know, first time to really step out and do something like that.
It sounds a little lighter, right?
I was really fortunate to work with people that like really got me, and when you write, it's all about the chemistry when you're with the people, and it was cool. It was a very cool experience.
God, I want to dance. I'm like, yeah.
Sometimes I get inspiration from, you know, having a great day, or, you know, just as simple as waking up in the morning and having a bowl of cereal and just talking about simple things. No, seriously, inspiration comes from a lot of things. And sometimes, you know, things that happen to you in your life, like in life situations, like with a relationship, with your family, your mom, or, you know, a boyfriend, you know, I draw inspiration from a lot of different things. I think that you get to a stage in your career where you're like, okay, I've done this, I've done that, and I think just the process of me going into something different and searching for something out, that in itself is making me open up and to learn even more. You know, the people who walk around saying, I'm very righteous, I'm done, and I'm spiritual, I'm not. I'm still learning right now. And I think that curiosity in life and that, you know, that whole thing right there just opens you up to a different level, and being vulnerable and admitting to that and, you know, still searching, because we all are.
In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Amen!
Amen. I'm kind of strong on stage. When I get on stage, I'm very, this is it, you know. But there gets to a point where that gets old. And, you know, you do it for so long and you're like, okay, you know, what? And it's about tapping, letting that go, you know, I think I did that after my last tour, and letting that go for a little bit and get in touch with yourself and feeling vulnerable and feeling like this, like you don't know things all, because what's fun in life if you know everything, you know? And then saying, you know, there's a lot out there that I don't know about, and adventuring out and going on that new journey, you know? But I think I've learned a lot lately, so I think Brittany's coming back. I think it was really cool because most performances, it's like this huge, big, broad thing, and the ABC thing, it was more of like a smaller environment. And the place that we shot it at was in itself. You could just film that and it was absolutely beautiful, but it was really cool because it felt intimate. And when you feel that with the audience and it's, you know, and the presentation of the songs were completely different, you know, they were changed up a little bit, you know, so it has more of an intimate feel so you can relate to the people more. And that's kind of the vibe that I kind of wanted for the tour coming up, even though I'm going to be playing in front of, you know, thousands of people and stuff. But still, the song, the whole show in general is going to be a little bit more intimate with the way I'm presenting myself to the people. It's more, on an intimate note. Well, at first we thought of just the Onyx tour, because Onyx is a black gemstone, and it's supposed to ward off evil, and they actually, this is real, like they have black stones in mimes and stuff like that Indians go to, and they're like really scared to even approach them because some of them are so strong and powerful, not in a bad way, but just the energy from them is like a spiritual thing. And the whole concept with the tour that I liked about it was that Onyx, whatever light is reflected on it, that's what it becomes. And it's kind of like being a character on a show. Whatever light is put on me, you know, performing as an entertainer and an artist, that's like, it's like you're not set in your ways. You just kind of express yourself, and that's what you become when that light is set on you. So I thought the whole Onyx thing was really, really cool, but then to have it in a show and to make it more general and to tie everything together, the Onyx Hotel, since I'm traveling so much and I'm always on the go and, you know, going, I thought, you know, to tie in a show called the Onyx Hotel, you know, there's a lot of things that we could do to, you know, make it smaller, because the Onyx just in itself is so broad. I think the Onyx Hotel kind of limits it a little bit, which is good, so it's not all over the place.
Brittany's gonna take the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for TRL Music and Britney Spears History.
That was really crazy. I was kind of nervous though, because I haven't, like, you know, performed in front of like a big crowd in a while, especially outside in TRL, but they were very welcoming. It was weird because they all kind of knew most of the words to the songs, like Boom Boom and stuff like that. I was like, this isn't even out yet. How are you knowing what's going on, you know? But it was cool. It was cool that they were kind of embracing everything and stuff like that. I thought Toxic, the whole, when you hear the song, it kind of sounds like this whole, I don't know, futuristic Mission Impossible type thing. So hearing the song, I thought it would be cool to have like a girl that was just on a mission, you know, to just kind of go out there and do her thing. And, you know, she's a villain, which was cool to play a bad, you know, vixen girl. And, you know, so just hearing the song, though, that's what kind of made me think of an impactful superhero type girl.